Tulhana, where he works as a migrant labourer. The 350-kilometer overnight journey will take him to Acharya Tulsi Regional Cancer Treatment and Research Institute in Bikaner in Rajasthan, where he's been treated for throat cancer. "This train is my lifeline," he says. "This is the journey of my life." For most of the patients on board Train 339, it is a journey of hope and pain. They have given the iron horse a name too. They call it the cancer train. The morbid nickname is actually an unfair one. An overnight journey in the train would leave you impressed by the fighting spirit of the doughty people who don't know what caused the misery. Once inside the train, the patients and their relatives are comrades in pain. They forget that only minutes earlier, they had been elbowing each other at the ticket counter or trying to outsmart each other to get a seat on the floor of the train. The regulars share their stories and homemade snacks. The lucky ones who get killed come with sweets and hearts full of hope for fellow soldiers. Train 339 starts her journey from Abohar in Punjab every evening at 7:40 p.m. After largely uneventful stops, it reaches Bathinda at 9 p.m. where hundreds of cancer patients like Swaran Singh and their relatives will be waiting. The train chugs through Punjab's cotton belt, stopping at various stations before finally reaching Bikaner at the crack of dawn. Most passengers disembark for the treatment in the center, and they wait for the train's trip to Abohar to head back home. In a region which doesn't even have a primary health center, the Cancer Institute in Bikaner is a blessing. The center was set up by Maharaja Ganga Singh of Bikaner, who imported a cobalt machine in 1922 when his son was diagnosed with cancer. The prince succumbed to the disease, but the hospital has since developed into a massive institution where 60,000 cancer patients are treated every year, almost free. But the shocking fact is that more than 65% of the hospital's patients are from Punjab, and especially from the southwest fertile belt of Malwa region of Punjab, which comprises the worst hit districts like Bathinda, Muktsar, Faridkot, Mansa, and Sanur. Mukhtiyar Kaur of Chajjar village in Bathinda thinks she got breast cancer because she beat her chest too much when her brother died. She has been a patient for the past 15 years. "If you want to live, go to the hospital in Bikaner," they told her neighbors. With no option, she undertook a 10-hour road journey to Bathinda to bear the pain in her leg. Another 9-hour journey. The doctors at Acharya Tulsi Regional Cancer Treatment and Research Center removed her left breast and gave her chemotherapy. 3 years later, Mukhtiyar Kaur sits patiently at the door of the hospital's cancer outpatient department for further checkups. Jaspreet Kaur. As screening facilities are inadequate in government hospitals, most cancer patients have no option but to go to quacks, says Jaspreet, 16, who is suffering from leukemia. She had decided to take up the medical screening class 11th so that she could be a cancer specialist one day to help her people. Ironically, when Jaspreet fell ill, her father took her to a quack. He thought taking her to Bikaner would affect her studies. Jinxed. This is a family from Bathinda who have a few generations which have had eye cancer in one eye, and these people are known as the Kani family. Kani is the Punjabi word for one-eyed people. Locating Darshan Singh's house in Bathinda isn't difficult at all, as everyone knows the Kani or the one-eyed family. Darshan Singh has his own tale to share. The disease tiptoed into the family 15 years ago when he had a son from his first wife. The baby must have been 7 or 8 months old when he developed a problem in one of the eyes. They lost him. Soon Darshan Singh lost his wife too. He has 3 children from his second wife. The eldest died of the same problem before she was 2. Now his youngest child, a 2-year-old baby girl, has caught it. No one knows what's in store for her. This is the story of Amarjeet Kaur. She has liver cancer. Her husband Mandar Singh is suffering from throat cancer. She and her husband have worked out a drill to get aboard the train. As soon as the train stops in Bathinda, she would rush to grab a seat while he would get the tickets at the counter. She had a little problem in her nose a few years back, but before she could do anything, it was all swollen and her face was deformed over days. As they had no hospital nearby, and thus Bikaner has become their weekly destination. So what does the hospital authorities have to say about that? I will not comment on the health machinery of any state, but it's true that majority of our patients are coming from the Malwa belt of Punjab, says Dr. M.R. Bhatia, director of the Acharya Tulsi Regional Cancer Treatment Research Institute in Bikaner. Most of them are in the secondary and tertiary stages of the disease, hinting at non or poor prognosis at the initial stages. We are able to save many lives, but unfortunately, we are yet to ascertain the reasons behind the same. So the main question arises is, are we cursed? Are we jinxed? What went wrong in this particular region of Punjab? What is the cause of this misery? Is there a remedy? Or will the suffering continue? Are we supposed to die like this? Let's see what some of these NGOs have to say in this context. According to a 2007 State of Environment report, Malwa consumes 75% of the total pesticide used in Punjab. Punjab's land is so addicted to fertilizers, thanks to the Green Revolution, that consumption in the state is 177 kilograms per hectare as compared to the 90 kilograms per hectare at the national level. The problem is so gross that even cattle fodder cannot be grown without fertilizers. Greenpeace research. In 2009, under a Greenpeace research laboratories investigation, Dr. Ray Stilado from the University of Exeter, UK, conducted a study in 50 villages in Muktsar, Bathinda, and Ludhiana districts that revealed chemical radiation and biological toxicity rampant in Punjab. 20% of the sampled wells showed nitrate levels above the safety limit of 50 milligrams per liter established by WHO. However, the study connected it with high use of synthetic nitrogen fertilizers and excessive use of pesticides. Kheti Virasat Mission report. According to the Kheti Virasat Mission, an NGO that works for agriculture and environment, farmers are caught in a cesspool of toxicity, a result of excessive and unregulated use of pesticides and chemical fertilizers, which have contaminated the groundwater. While the urban people live off the prosperity generated by the crops, the farmers are left to deal with the byproduct cancer, which originates from sprays containing acephate, chloropropene, diuron, fluomipron, pentimethalin, triphosphate, and triclosan. With increasing poisoning of the soil, the region once hailed as home to the Green Revolution, now due to the excessive use of chemicals and pesticides and fertilizers, is being termed the other Bhopal. What are the government's initiatives regarding the same? The first door-to-door survey was conducted in 2011 by Mr. P.L. Garg, former registrar of Baba Farid University of Health Sciences, Faridpur, and Karnail Singh Jakhepal, General Secretary of the Internationalist Democratic Party. It revealed that about 8,000 people died of cancer in Punjab every year. The survey conducted among 65,000 people in 23 villages of Malwa belt of Punjab created a storm, getting political parties into various promise trees which did not prove fruitful. But it took the deaths of an MLA from Punjab, Mr. Kamaljit Singh Brown, who was the legislator from Muktsar, and Mrs. Surinder Kaur Badal, who was the wife of the former Chief Minister of Punjab, Mr. Prakash Singh Badal, for the government to announce a relief package of up to Rs. 1.5 lakh per patient to cancer centres. Records say that at least Rs. 24 crore have already been released for the treatment of 2,222 cancer patients. But how far has it reached into right hands is a big question. So here I would like to put an input. Since I am working with Red Cross in the past couple of months, and what I have seen is that we are receiving lots of applications for cancer patients to get some aid, maybe in the form of money or like paying off the hospital bill or. So it clearly indicates, I have spoken to a couple of patients and I have told them to go and get this grant of Rs. 1.5 lakh from the hospital authorities or the health officials and all. So what the patients tell me, the feedback that's coming back is, it's such a tedious process that most of the patients don't even want to go to the hospital asking for a grant of this much amount of money. So instead, they try approaching some charities, NGOs, Red Cross, and so many other institutions like that, because they think it's much more easier to get money from there or maybe get some kind of financial aid from there. The government is, of course, it has started the scheme in Punjab, but how far it's proved useful is still a matter of concern. So government screening program. The data that the government screening program at schools for early detection of cancer through was qualifying. At least 200 school children across the state of Punjab were identified as early cancer patients in the screening. Former Union Rural Development Minister Mr. Jairam Ramesh confirmed the presence of uranium and other heavy metals in groundwater in the state, particularly Malwa. He admitted that substantial quantities of uranium, arsenic, mercury, and other heavy metals have been found in the tested samples of groundwater in Punjab. Of the 2,462 samples of water collected from tubewells across Punjab, 1,140 samples had tested positive for the presence of uranium and arsenic, at some places even 50% higher than the WHO limits. The last UPA government had promised to give Punjab ₹525 crores to make its water uranium free, and water testing laboratory at Mohali has already come up another scheme. Another input here is that I don't know how far these so-called RO filters are effective in filtering uranium and other heavy metals, but these RO companies, they are minting a lot of money, in particularly this belt of Punjab. The RO filter sales have, I mean, shoot up exponentially in the Marwar belt. People are not aware, people have, I mean, nowhere to go to. The government has also set up some RO plants, RO filter plants in different villages of Punjab as well in order to filter water. But people are buying these RO plants in bulk. The sales have shot exponentially, and obviously the corporations are making money out of this as well. They are making money out of the misery of people, undoubtedly. So how far is that effective? I'm still to see. Well, like, there is this one particular village near Bhatinda, Tarani Sabu. It's quite a popular place back there. It has some religious significance as well, and it's a good tourist place also. So that village had 600 children at that particular point of time when I was studying this. So out of the 600 children of the village, 150 children were already, they were born with some or the other sort of mental retardation or some deformity. It's not uncommon to see polydactyly and MR cases in the Malwa belt. So I think that is my personal opinion as well. I think the medical journals would also support this, that the uranium, extensive level of uranium toxicity could have something to do with this as well. So that now we have, like, the state's two biggest coal run thermal power plants are in and around Bhatinda. The Observer's investigation. An investigation carried out by the Observer newspaper in 2009 revealed the possibility that the cause of contamination of soil and groundwater in Malwa region of Punjab could be the fly ash from coal burnt at thermal power plants, which contain high levels of uranium and ash, as the region has state's two biggest coal-fired power stations. Another hypothesis is that this extensive level of uranium in the southwest region of Punjab could have originated from nearby Tosham Ring complex, called Tosham Hills in Bhiwani, Haryana, where night crops are present in a large number. But again, it's a hypothesis. Whatever comes up in the future researches can, you know, prove it wrong also. But this is again. Then there was one more hypothesis, that all this uranium is coming from the Gulf War hit regions. I mean, the wind is blowing the uranium particles from the Gulf hit regions where this war is going on, and it's getting deposited in Punjab. But again, the point is that if it is like that, why hasn't Pakistan been reporting such cases? Because the ash is obviously flying across Pakistan, then coming to Punjab. So yeah, there are a couple of things that have to be sorted out in this. So tests on groundwater carried out by Dr. Chandra Prakash, a veteran ecologist, and Dr. Surinder Singh, also at Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar, found the highest average concentration of uranium, 56.95 micrograms per liter, in the town of Kuchumandi in Bhatinda, a short distance from the ash pond of Lehra Mohabbat Thermal Power Plant. The graduate situation increases with a lack of affordable and quality cancer treatment in the nearby areas. As a result, boarding the cancer train is the last resort for a common man. Though train 339 has been a lifeline for many, there are still many who have nothing much to gain from it. Such is the case of Lakhvinder Singh. The train of arguments nor the availability of train has made any life any difference to the life of Lakhvinder Singh. He is 24, has been to Bikaner. The doctors have barred him from getting married, nor can he work in his fields anymore. Cancer has killed both his testicles. Thanks for patient listening. Again, one more input I would like to add here is that the government has come up with a proposed nuclear power plant at Gorakhpur, Fatehabad in Haryana. And Fatehabad is within the 100-mile radius of this region of Punjab, Bhatinda, which is already so badly hit by the uranium toxicity, and so badly hit by the cancer and other ailments, that I don't know how it's going to come up for the people of that particular area. Particularly with a new uranium and a nuclear power plant coming up in the similar locality, it's going to be really tough for the communities to thrive and survive.